Hello everyone, this is Quiversee and welcome back to some more of Mario and Rabbids Kingdom Battle. Last time we began our adventure, in this land. There's a lot of things, again, that are questionable in this setting, but shouldn't be for the sake of sanity. But yeah, like I said, we began last time and now it looks like we are about to have ourselves another battle. Oh, it's a Ziggy. Oh, he's running straight for us. What a jerk.
From FB to Beepo. Dear Beepo, if one is to prevail, one must practice. Please sharpen your movement skills so you can turn the tables on those rascally rabbits. I've just uploaded a few suggestions to help you guide your team in the next battle. Quick, sign your biggest fan.
Okay then. Extra health. I don't know what that is.
You can deal damage while on the move by performing a dash. Select a cell with an enemy and press A. Also, you can cover more ground with a team jump. Select a cell with an ally and press A. How about an epic combo? After you dash an enemy, perform a team jump with an ally.
I completely forgot about this feature. So, yeah, I can dash into that guy and then run over here and proceed to shoot him in the face. I had completely forgotten about that. And one of the cool things about this game, unlike a lot of other tactical strategy games like Fire Emblem, for example, is you can move pretty freely around here. Like, I don't have to worry about running out of movement or anything. Like, if this was, like, a Fire Emblem game or something, I'd be able to move here and then maybe move one more square, two at best. But if I wanted to, I could dash there and then run all the way over here. No sweat. It's actually pretty cool. Now we can do ourselves a team jump. I can't jump on the enemy. I think that's something we might get the power to do later, but I'm not entirely sure. Let's do this for now. And bam. And then we shoot in the face. And now with Rabbid Peach, we will once more jump atop Mario. And yeah, as you can see, we can't do a team jump on another team jump. So we'll just go over here. And Rabbid Peach is poised to murder. And she's proud of it. Look at that face. Unfortunately, I think this guy, yeah, he's gonna get an easy shot. And enemies can also dash into you as well. Ah! Luckily, he attacked the brick, and you noticed it popped out a coin. You can actually gain coins by damaging certain obstacles in the environment. It's not exactly lucrative, but it is something worth keeping in mind. Like, if you have to make a choice between attacking an enemy that's, like, behind cover that won't take damage if you hit it, and one that would if you hit it. You'd always want to hit the one that would, just for that reason, if not just because, you know, getting rid of the cover can also make it easier to attack the enemy. A lot of interesting little details in the strategy in this game. But we're still in, like, super basic land. Let's see, there's a switch down there, but we can't go down. Like I mentioned before, we're literally just controlling the little Roomba guy here, Beepo. So we can't do basic things like jump. Just as an example.
It's broken for now, though considering how dangerous it is, I have a hard time believing the rabbits won't fix it.
I don't remember what the requirements are to unlock a cannon like that with the angry face on it, but we'll have to come back to that later. So I guess nothing we can do for now except keep pushing forward. And by forward, I guess I mean underground. Oh, here we go. Button. And that's how you unlock it, with a button. Okay. So now that we've done that, I can go and hit the cannon. Ah, And looks like there's another battle over there. Yeah, any I never really mentioned it. Anytime you see those black pirate-looking rabbit flags, that's a sign that there's a battle there. So anytime you have a battle, it's going to be indicated. And if you have those blue castle flags, then it's a battle you've already done. So makes it pretty easy to keep tabs on what to expect going forward. We have acquired Rabbid Peach. I don't remember what those... I think those might be like statues or something. Like figurines. But I'm not 100% sure. I guess we'll find out when we have the chance to actually look at items. Which I don't know if we'll get that far today. I kind of hope so, but I don't know. I'll worry about that in a minute. I'm going to hit the Y button. Restore your team's HP and get 50% extra health. I don't know what that's for, but it's interesting that that's an option.
It's time to pull together everything you've learned so far. Attack, movement, team jump, dash, don't forget about cover. You can also switch heroes anytime using L and R, and between attack and move using ZL and ZR. Your best.
Yep. You can attack and then move, or you can move and then attack. You don't have to worry about it. And as you can see on the bottom right, if you press Y, you can just skip straight to the enemy's turn. No sweat. So I'm just going to dash, and you'll notice I can't dash again. So I've got to go... I can't dash into multiple enemies with a single character. So we'll just blast them. All right, next we got Rabbid Luigi. Let's pop him over... Let's put him over here. Give him a nice dash into that Ziggy. Oh, that did a little more than I realized, actually. But oh wait, no, that was the one that was already hit. Never mind, I'm stupid. So then we're gonna put Rabbid Peach behind cover. So in this setup, Mario and Rabbid Peach are both potentially gonna get hit by the guys up ahead, but Rabbid Luigi is completely safe. There ain't no way he's getting hit. So you're going for Peach. And she's fine. How about you? And she's still fine. And her cover is also still fine, although it's definitely seen better days. So Rabbid Peach is here. She can dash into that guy behind the full cover. I'm gonna let her stay there for a moment and use her as a springboard for Mario. Actually, hang on. Rabbid Luigi, what can you do? From here. I don't think I can go anywhere that'll get this guy in a position that's good. So I'm just gonna take advantage of this. Rabbid Luigi is likely to get hit doing this. But I want to get rid of this guy. Okay, that's good. Now for Mario. Wish I could just blast him. I can't go there though. Okay, this is a good spot. I'm trying to do what I can to prevent my guys from getting damaged. And there we go, luck was on my side. So now I'll just dash into that guy with Rabbid Peach, and I will run straight back to where I am. And what the hey, I'll damage his cover too. After all, it is a brick. All right, he can dash. I didn't think he was in dash distance. And now Rabbid Peach's bricks are gone, but we got a couple of coins for our trouble. So that works. Let's use Rabbid Luigi as a springboard and finish this guy off. Looks like I'm gonna have to use Mario to finish it. Unless Rabbid Luigi can run that far in dash. Not quite. All right then, Mario it is. Just bounce over here. And shoot him in the face. Yep. All right. That's another perfect. And we finished another world, as it were, so we got healed again. In case that isn't clear, that's how it's determined. Also, I suppose I'll go ahead and mention the way that the perfect operates is that there's two categories. You can kind of see there's the turns and the team status. Turns is just you need to beat it within a certain amount of turns, and team status is whether that character survives the battle or not. So because we took, you know, we did it within four turns in the first battle and within three turns in the second battle and nobody died, that's why we got all points. That's how that's addressed.
Mario, the creature with the headset, got away. But I suppose you did clean up his mess. And being a plant of my word, it looks like I owe you a reward.
Our good friends Rabbit Luigi and Rabbit Peach helped as well.
Yeah, yeah, great.
We got a coin! I don't think Rabbit Luigi Rabbit Peach liked that too much.
Okay, okay. Here.
There we go, that's what I'm talking about. Way to go with your powers of persuasion there, Rabbit Peach. And we got Sunflower. Wow.
Just so you know, there are lots of things you can buy with coins. You just gotta find a place to spend them.
Coins are indeed very important. If I recall correctly, even when I had 100% completion, I still had some stuff I could have bought with coins that I couldn't afford because I didn't have enough. So, very high odds we won't get everything. But over here, we have our first instance of an obstacle we can't deal with. Beepo hasn't learned how to do this yet. As you can see, we have a block here. It's got ropes on it. One wonders why Mario, or one of the rabbits, but especially Mario, who is known for, you know, jumping over tiny gaps or solving basic puzzles, couldn't just, you know, hop over there and get the box. I need to follow my own advice. I need to stop questioning some of this nonsense. Maybe it has something to do with the merging of the worlds. I don't know. Okay, let's see. So down here is another area with some of these blocks that we can't interact with. That's one thing I actually don't really like, is that there are some things that just like, oh, you can't do this until you get the power to do a thing. So you have to come back later. It just feels a little arbitrary. But, you know, no game's perfect. What's going on down there?
Hey, you! It's a stripe on a garden hose, not a border! Don't let your love be divided!
Who's to say that that's what they're doing? They might just be wondering what it actually is. They might just be curious. Might not have something to do with them thinking that it's a border. Also, wow, if that's a garden... Oh, geez. Yeah, that is a garden hose, and it's all tied up in knots. That center is bound to burst if they're not careful. Also, it's Toad!
Mario, thank goodness you're here! Yours is the first friendly face I've seen since the Mushroom Kingdom turned into this mess. Your timing couldn't be more perfect! I can't find Toadette!
All thanks to the changes caused by these odd pipes our rabid friends brought with them into your world.
You guys seem to know what you're doing, sort of. Could you help me find her? Please?
Okay, but you're gonna see firsthand how big of a pain these pipes are.
Oh, no, they're not that bad. They're just like any other pipe.
Maybe, but they look so cool.
I'll be quiet.
Seriously, these pipes are not any... I mean, they're a little creepy, but they're otherwise not any different than, like, the clear pipes from 3D World. Or just, you know, a standard warp pipe. That being said, that one was definitely more lengthy and convoluted than it needed to be. And now we have a choice. A choice of which cannon to take. Well, this one clearly leads over to just a platform with money on it. And a blue cannon. I don't remember what this is. Oh, I kind of do remember these now. This is another treasure challenge. Gotta get the blue coins. All right, take the pipe. Okay, got 12 seconds left, and we got this. The isometric perspective makes this a little tricky to control, like, properly. Also, I love how they have little footprints there, and I don't know why, I only just now noticed that Toad is actually following us, like, as if he was part of our party. Oh, what do we got? The turbine, another new weapon. Looks like that's for Rabbid Luigi, but we can't do anything with that yet. So let's leave the digital blue zone. And we're right back where we were, only the cyber cannon is now gone. So let's go down this pipe. I wasn't supposed to go in this pipe, was I? Or was I? I was. Okay, we're good. And that's a... That's a switch that needed to exist. I guess it's to show that switches can manipulate pipes in this world. Which is helpful information to have, to be fair. Hey, look, it's Toadette. We found her. Toadette, I'm so glad you're okay.
Oh, I'm fine. What I'm really worried about is Princess Peach. Mario, can you go back to Peach's castle and make sure everything's all right?
Certainly not. We need to find... Rabbid face before! Another message! From FB to Beepo. Congratulations on getting this far. A wise man once said, if I have 3 hours to chop a tree, I will spend two of them sharpening my axe. I urge you now to return to Princess Peach's castle and do just that. Prepare yourselves for the fight to come. Well, that's all well and good, but how? You may be wondering, how? In the time it took you to read this email, I have updated your operating system. It now includes a new GPS warp mechanism I call Spoing! The name is a work in progress. Anyhow, simply activate it, and you and your friends will return to Princess Peach's castle immediately. Sign, your biggest fan. Well, that's amazing if true. I suppose I should give it a...
And we have been forcefully sploinged. That sounds very wrong now that I say it out loud. Either way, welcome to Peach's castle, complete with sticky mushrooms and Goombas. And Princess Peach!
Mario! Thank heavens you're all right! It's so good to see you. You've probably noticed this, but the Mushroom Kingdom's been torn apart! You have to do something, Mario! Who are your new friends?
I'm just laughing at the sign in the background.
Allow me, Your Highness. I am Beepo, an autonomously intelligent scientific research and operational assistant. Yay!
I see, and...
We call this one Rabbid Luigi. And this is Rabbid Peach. She's taking her cosplay a bit too seriously, I'm afraid.
Are you trying to imply that Peach herself is, like, the standoffish narcissist? Well, then again, she was unveiling a gigantic statue of herself for, like, no real reason. Does Rabbid Peach know something we don't? Wow. Meanwhile, Rabbid Luigi is liking other rabbits. As they're just running around doing their thing.
Yes, the friends are also quite, spirited, as you can see.
It appears as if the rabbits we freed from the Megabug's control have ended up here. And no worse for wear, either.
That's the first time we've heard the term Megabug. Beepo? The heck's a Megabug? I legit don't remember.
Wow. That's right! They keep popping in just like you did!
Yep, Rabbids just falling out of the sky.
Yeah. Oh yes, they've been
quite busy. I suggest you take a look at what they've built if you have a chance.
They have built many things.
I believe there's something called a battle HQ? And then there's the museum. They love to collect souvenirs from the Mushroom Kingdom.
Come, let us see for yourselves what your rabbit cousins have been up to.
Indeed.
Yeah, let's take a look around before anything's today.
Yeah, I was looking at this sign in the background earlier. It's so stupid and I love it.
I'm not so thrilled with the rabbit's work thus far. Let's hope this little project of theirs is more constructive.
Well, they're at the very least good at pretending to be constructive.
A fossilized spiny shell. We must find a way to restore it, and then spend the rest of our lives trying to avoid it.
You know how you would avoid it? Fossilizing it! Endless cycle confirmed. But yeah, this is basically a hub area of sorts. And it has its own little trove of secrets. Some of it will open up more as we've gone. Geyser Goombas, that's a new artwork. So that's what that is. But yeah, parts of this area will just open up as we progress. As we saw, there was that little gate near the construction site, and the construction site itself will open up. Here's Peach's now destroyed statue.
It took the Mushroom Kingdom Department of Public Works 3 years just to get the permits for this statue.
Why? It's a statue of the literal ruler of the kingdom. Does she not want it? Like, why would it take 3 years to get the permits for a statue of your ruler? That's kind of silly. Ancient Gardens version 0, a gold artwork. I don't recall what makes a gold artwork special. But it certainly seems special. Anyways, the Battle HQ is probably the single most important area here. Ah, yes. So I mentioned before I had gotten all the DLC. We got the steampunk and pixel weaponry. So there are three sections here: team, weapons, and skill tree. We can't really do anything on skill tree. And while we have access to team, we don't have access to any other characters. Right now we've just got Mario and two rabbits. So you can see, oh, didn't mean to do that. right. So here we can at the very least take a look at their stats. Yeah. We can see, you know, their primary weapon for Peach and Mario, it's the blaster. For Rabbit Luigi, it's a warb, which is basically just a yo-yo. And a whole bunch of different stats, including how far they can move, how much damage their dashes do. Like, Rabbit Luigi's dash is actually pretty strong. And how far they can move after jumping or coming out of a pipe, which is another feature we haven't actually encountered in battle yet. And a little description, like, you know, Mario's offensive talents make him a natural choice to lead the charge in battle. He's basically just a good all-around offensive character. Rabbit Peach is a healer and a damage dealer. We haven't seen any powers about healing yet, but that is something we'll get into later. Apparently she has one eye on the enemy and one on Mario. No comment. And then Rabbit Luigi, who is apparently defensive and has the power of elemental forces. Again, another feature we'll look into later. So I'll just exit there. And then we have our weapon selection. So we have ourselves blasters, which, even though they're the same kind of weapon, Mario and Rabbit Peach have different ones altogether. So right now Mario has a choice between Lightning Shark, Elena Shell, which I'm going to, I gotta buy them, right? That's right, you have to unlock it and then you have to buy it. That's the thing. The Rumble Bee, which you can see that these weapons actually have something else: bounce damage and honey damage. Those are actually the elements we were talking about before, and those will become a little bit more relevant later. But I'm just going to equip this, the Fragmenter. That is part of the Pixel Pack DLC, so it's basically just an upgrade I get right away, and it's better than anything I could buy anyway. Do I have anything else? Just taking a look. Nope. All right, Rabbit Peach, we got the Fuchsia Fury, the Red Wasp, and the Retro Deflator. which I'm going to go ahead and snag. And another thing that some of the weapons have is bonus damage against certain types of enemies. Hoppers are a type we haven't encountered yet, but Ziggies is one we have, and I didn't mean to go there, I meant to go here. And we can see that this has bonus damage against those. So that gives an idea of what to look for there. I don't think there's any other weapons. Doggone it, I keep doing that. And then we've got the Dwarf Star, Slam Held, the Turbine, which is the one that we found. A lot of these weapons are actually really cool looking, and I especially dig these pixel ones. Which, in reality, they're more like voxel, but, you know, that's just a 3D pixel anyway, it doesn't matter. Point is, they look really cool, and they're also the strongest weapons we've got, and this one does push damage, so that's different. And I do believe that is all we've got. So that's all we can do in the Battle HQ for now. I'm gonna save my coins. Because those pixel weapons will definitely not be top slot for long. This... Okay, so yeah, World 1 Ancient Gardens. This takes us back to the actual level. And over here is the museum. Let's take a look at that. So we found ourselves a little bit of art. I guess this one's geyser Goombas. And there's... Okay, yeah, we can just do that. So this is the golden one. I guess the golden ones might be like some concept art or something. I honestly don't know. It is really nice though. I think this is one of my favorite ones so far. It's like, I like it more than this, that's for sure. But that is still really good. Like, these are actually really well done. Why is that one still an explanation? Oh, because I didn't, okay. And then we got models. So we got Mario, Rabbit Peach. Can I rotate? Okay, there we go. I had to push A. And, okay, I have to go out to do that. And Sunflower. That Sunflower is such a narcissist. And then we have Taros. I don't remember those, like, at all. But I guess that'll be for later. Oh!
Aha! Look over there! These clever rabbits have outfitted a cannon so that it can launch us back to the ancient gardens. This comes in handy as our mysterious helper gave me the power to warp to Princess Peach's castle. And the cannons can send us back to the front. The ability to return to Princess Peach's castle at will has been added to the pause menu.
That's pretty helpful. There's one other thing I want to look at before I wrap up, though, and that's... I can't go in there.
The Megabug damaged the rabbit's combo washer and time machine, else I'd take a trip to the French Baroque period.
I still am curious about the, logistics of this world. And, like, the world that Beepo is from in comparison to the rabbits. Okay, we can't go there yet. That's another world that I was just poking around at. Got another one of those construction yards we can't do anything with. There's something I'm trying to see if I can actually get access to. And also I'm just trying to get some coins. A lot of these coins actually do respawn, so it's worth going out of your way to grab some if you have something you want to grab. I think I'm coming up to the... Yeah, I'm on the other side of that fence. I don't know why that fence is even there if I can get to the other side with relative ease. Yeah, that's another world, and we're not going there right now. In reality, those are the real reason why they have, like, the skills and such, which, again, I feel like they could have done better than having, like, the overworld skills. Like, what I'm talking about is the, you know, when we found that block that we can't push because people can't do that yet. That's what I mean. I really feel like they could have handled that a little better. But, yeah, the thing I was actually looking for, I don't think we can do from here yet. But we did get another figurine, this one of Toadette. I think there was one more pipe I ran past, so I'm gonna go there real quick. Let's go around. Yeah, it was like right around the washing machine. Here. Grab the coins and get ourselves another music track. The Ziggy's Battle. And I think that is all we can do in the hub world for the time being. So that's where we're going to wrap up now. Next time on Mario and Rabbids Kingdom Battle, we are going back to the Ancient Gardens. And gonna put our new pixel weapons to the test. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.